Hello traders, for backtesting purposes we may find useful to have multiple instances of the same trading platform installed on the same computer. We will do just that. First, we must identify the data folder of the MT4 trading platform we are using, and from the file menu we open the data folder and we open another window, and we will navigate in this local computer to the location where our MT4 platform is installed. In this case is this PC, local disk C, program files x86, and the folder is MetaTrader 4. So we have two folders. One is the data folder and one is the folder that contains the application itself. Now that we've identified the files we need, we may close the platform itself and let's make a folder on the desktop. We will call it testing platforms and navigate to see its contents. Now the folder is empty. In this folder we can create how many trading platforms we want and their copies if we want multiple copies of those trading platforms. We'll call it the first one MT4 test 1. And in this folder we will copy the entire contents of the MetaTrader 4 folder from the program files, and then on top of that the entire content of the data folder of the same trading platform we want to copy. Now that we have all the files united in the same folder, we must do a little trick to convince this application to run from this specific folder and not from its previous location. The application itself is this file, terminal.exe, and we will create a shortcut to the application itself, and we will modify this newly created shortcut properties in such a way that in the target field, at the end of the target field, we append /portable. And another useful thing, in the advanced tab we may want to tick run as administrator. Apply and OK. And now on our desktop, in this folder, we have another folder that contains our trading platform. How do we launch that? We are launching this MT4 trading platform not by launching the terminal application, but by launching the shortcut we've created. If we will be launching the application using the terminal itself, then the MT4 trading platform will launch, but it will use as its data folder another location than the location we want it to use, which is the folder on our desktop. So we are launching the MT4 using our shortcut, and this way all the files that this platform will use are contained in this folder. Here we'll have the files needed for the application to run and all the indicators, expert advisors, sounds, profiles, and so on and so forth. Now that we have a copy of our trading platform and we verified that by launching it this way we are running within this particular folder, we may copy this folder how many times we want, and that way we will have our MT4 test 2 platform, and why not test 3, test 4, or how many other we want to have. For each one of the copies we are making, we have to make sure that the shortcut is pointing to the correct target. In this case, we delete the shortcut and create a new one, doing the same two little tricks. At the end of the target, we append forward slash portable, and in the advanced tab, we tick the run as administrator, apply, and OK. MT4 test 3. Again, we delete the old shortcut and create a new one. We modify its properties, appending at the end of the target forward slash portable, and in the advanced tab, run as administrator. Now, if we want to run this one, we use its shortcut. If we want to run this one, we use its own shortcut, and that way we may run simultaneously multiple trading platforms at the same time. For each one, we can create demo accounts or we can use the same demo account for all of them if we want to. This one is connected to that demo account. This one can be connected
incoming mail
to the same demo account or to another demo account. It doesn't really matter as long as it runs independently. And this is how we create and install multiple copies of the same trading platform on the same system.
To see more, please subscribe, give us a thumb up and share our clips.